You're not really ready until you're safe. Summer safely and drive calm.
Trying to quit smoking? You don't have to quit alone. Way to Quit is here if you need help, have questions, or just need to talk. Tips, resources, and coaches are just a phone call away. Call 1-800-QUIT-NOW. That's 1-800-QUIT-NOW or visit waytoquit.org.
Inside Sources. Where KSL offers Utah deeper insights on the news. Host Boyd Matheson divides rage from reason and elevates the conversation on issues crucial to our community. On KSL News Radio 102.7 FM and 1160 AM.
Welcome back to Inside Sources here on KSL News Radio. It's great to be with you today, and I've been looking forward since last Friday. I've been looking forward to this conversation because we often joke at my house. We invoke the Incredibles often, and of course, in the Incredibles, there's the classic line: "If everybody's special, nobody's special." And our good friend Jonathan Johnson, CEO of Overstock.com, penned a brilliant piece in the Salt Lake Tribune late last week. Talking about this idea of special, and if everything is special, nothing is special, especially when it comes to the Utah legislature. And Jonathan joins us now. Thank you for popping in on a Monday.
Thank you, Boyd. It's always good to be on your show.
Wonderful. So just to be very clear at the outset here, you were not criticizing what was on the agenda for the special session of the Utah legislature, but you raised some really important points in terms of how our legislature functions, and maybe a way to focus it just a little bit better.
Yeah, you know, last week we had a special session of the legislature. Ours is a limited legislature that's supposed to meet 45 days a year for its general session. And then on occasion, something might arise for it to meet again. We're increasingly seeing these special sessions called many times through the year. There were four or five last year. Well, here we are in May. We've already had another. I think it would be useful to use the term that the Utah Constitution uses for these sessions, and that would be to call them extraordinary sessions.
Yeah, and I think that's one, it's interesting that that is what it says in the Utah Constitution, extraordinary. And so how do you think that will change the dynamic or the conversation if we go back to the proper term, constitutional term of extraordinary?
Well, hopefully it would mean there are less of them. And I think special sessions or extraordinary sessions are problematic, Boyd, for three reasons. One, most of the deals about legislation that happens in these extraordinary sessions is done ahead of time, outside of the public eye. There's backroom deals.
Behind closed doors is the...
Yes, the inside baseball term, behind closed doors. You know, if there is something that needs debate, the sessions are called with such short notice. This last one was called on a Friday and held on a Wednesday. It makes it difficult for those that have issues with the proposed legislation, the amount of campaign and time to have their voice heard. And because of that, the third reason is, frankly, it encourages citizen apathy. When you don't think you have a say, either because it's behind closed doors or because you can't mount an objection, ultimately we become apathetic. And that is three things that I think are problematic with these so-called special sessions.
Yeah, and I think the third one is the one that worries me the most, that if citizens feel like, well, there's no way I can organize, or there's no way I can research that, you know, in 24 hours and then show up, or if there is a sense that the behind closed doors action took place before the special session, the extraordinary session happened, very easy for citizens to disconnect. One of the interesting things, and you've raised this in various formats, and it's just an interesting conversation, you know, that Utah does have this 45-day session, so it is a citizen legislature to be sure, probably one of the few really left in the country. And does that still work? Is it time to consider full-time legislative action? And then that, of course, has its own set of dynamics and challenges.
Well, Bart, I hope we don't go to a professional full-time legislature in Utah. You know, I'm reminded of a quip that is attributed to Mark Twain, who said, "No man's life, liberty, or property are safe while the legislature is in session." And I think Utah benefits in being a well-run state by having citizen legislators in session for a limited calendar. And, you know, whether 45 days is long enough, I don't know. Since I penned that up and it was published, I've had several legislators reach out to me saying, "Well, you hit the nail on the head. We are slowly but surely becoming a full-time legislature when you have the general session to special after special after special, never yeah. extraordinary session that we have."
Yeah. Wow. Fascinating stuff. It's a great piece in Salt Lake Tribune. You can check that out there. And Jonathan, always appreciate your insight. And this is one that I think we've got to continue to stay with in terms of a question, because I'm with you. I think part of the reason we're one of the best run states is because we don't have a full-time legislature. But if we continue to add those specials, I think that's going to be the inevitable conclusion of that. But again, we'll keep this conversation rolling. Jonathan Johnson, CEO of Overstock.com. Great insight as always. Appreciate your leadership. Appreciate your voice.
Thank you, Boyd. And anytime we can talk to the Incredibles, I know it's been a good day.
It's been a good day. That's right. And because you're extraordinary, not special. So you're different. Thanks, Jonathan.
Thank you, Boyd.
Great conversation. And yeah, if everybody's special, if everything is special, nothing's special. And when it comes to legislative sessions, if everything's a special session, it's not that special. We're having too many. Let's go back to the Constitution. Radical stuff. Let's go with the term extraordinary. Might make everyone think through just a little harder what should be in those sessions and why. Most important, we need to make sure that we keep the citizens engaged in the process. All right, we'll take a quick timeout for a commercial break. When we come back, we're going to talk about the environment. Tom Carter's going to join us coming up next.
I'm Dave Cawley, host of the podcast Cold. Our brand new second season focuses on the 1985 disappearance of a woman named Joyce Yost. Hear her voice for the first time. That's Cold Season 2, exclusively on Amazon Music.